Power Director Tutorials with Power Director 16. Let's have a look at transitions and how we use them. In this particular video, I've got a bluebird and down here it's all cut up. And you'll see I've got these different places cut out. Now, if I move this forward a little bit and we play this section, notice how it kind of jumps and it gives that little jerk there. See that? And then it kind of goes through, and then we got our next one. So you got that jerking. But if I put a transition in there, it would probably look a whole lot better. So with PowerDirector 16, we can go into the transition room, which is up here, and we can hit F8 or just click it, and we come down with all these transitions. You can actually choose from, and there's all kinds of them. It's just unbelievable how many you've got to select from. Like if I select all, I've got 156 of them, and you can actually download a whole bunch from their website too. Now the transition we're going to want here, where we go from one to the other, is fade is the one we're going to want. So I'm going to do a search for fade, and there it is there. Now I'm going to grab the timeline, spread this out so this way I could see a little bit better. Grab the fade and kind of drop it between the lines. You see how I got it dropped between the lines there? And release. I'm going to do the same thing over here and release. And I'm going to do the same thing over here and release. This is going to make it look a little bit better when you do a transition. It'll back it up and we'll play it. So when you have a transition in PowerDirector 16, you don't get that jerkiness. So now you get like this smooth fade out, fade in. You see how that faded out and faded in? So just putting your videos together is not usually a very good idea. You kind of using a transition just gives it that extra professionalism to it, I guess you could say, you know. And you see how the one bird was on top of each other when it ran in transition. Now, let's take this a bit further, and I'm going to kind of mess around with this a little bit. I'm going to go to the effects room of FX. I'm going to go to style, and you guys don't have to do this. And I'll drop this right on there. I'll drop this right on there. Right on there. And basically I'm giving it that Sin City look is what I'm doing. Click on my effects. And I'm going crazy to save time here. I have a video that'll show you how to do this with the Sin City, but let's get a really sharp looking video here if you want to try this. '91 looks good. So we're probably gonna have to do the same thing here to 91. Or at least close. And then I'm going to go over to the next one. Effect. Give me that blue. Take that down to 91.2. And the next one. Give me this one. Give me a blue color on this one. There we go. Take it down to 92. Okay. So now we've got transitions. We've got that Sin City type of look. So let's give that a shot and see how this all looks. Get it to start over. And that looks really cool. You know, we got the blue jay and we got the black background and how that faded in, faded out. Pretty, pretty awesome. Okay. So I suppose we could add maybe a little music to this And that would give us a much better sharp. See that fade in, fade out? That just makes it look like, boom, that just makes it snap, you know? Makes that guy look really good. It's a little tiny bit blurry because I really didn't get, it's hard following a blue jay around with your camera, believe it or not, and videotaping it. But I like how it's all faded in. Now I guess I could play around with this a little further and I could go to fix and enhance when I click on the video. And maybe we could do some video stabilization. Okay. Bring that up a little bit. I'll do the same thing here. And I'll give them all some video stabilization. And let's find out. Okay. Apply to all. We're really, really editing this pretty good here. Okay. Looks a lot smoother. Here comes the fade. There's the transition in, transition out. That looks nice. I like it. Wish my camera would have been focused a little bit better. That's not bad. Not bad at all. I love how that fade in, fade out works. And we got ourselves a bird. That looks really good. Could use this as an intro. Could use it as a back if I wanted to at the end of a video on YouTube, which would really get a lot of attention for people. That looks really cool. So this video was about PowerDirector 16 and using your transitions so your videos don't look blocked. So that way when you put a transition in there, it looks a lot more professional for you.